I'm Cyndy Ama Ajago. Welcome to My Take. Over the years, the school has recorded a series of unprecedented events surrounding students' elections on campus. But there's good news. In an attempt to avoid the reoccurrence of such events, we are here on the interactive segment of My Take. Join me as we unravel our students' political hopefuls and get to know their policies. Today I have here with me Team Nana Yaa in the person of Miss Grace Afari Mensah. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
You look good.
Thank you. Not looking bad.
Thank you. So you vying for the position of SRC Secretary.
Yes, yes.
But I want to know you. Tell me about Miss Grace.
Okay, Cyndy. I'm Grace Afari Mensah.
Okay.
But then you can call me Nana Yaa. Right. That's what most students know me to be. Mm-hmm. Yes, I'm in level 300 and I read economics and geography.
Okay.
Currently, I'm the additional hall secretary, and then right. I'm contesting for SRC secretary. So you can imagine the kind of experience I've gathered so far. Yeah, and then the good thing is that as you work, you learn. Mm. Okay, you learn, you grow, you develop yourself. So it's just that this opportunity came, and then I still need to develop myself. Mm. The fact that you work and then you learn a lot motivates you to do more, because you keep increasing your self-value,
right.
And then you get to experience a whole lot that develops you in all. So that's the thing that motivates me to go and contest for the SRC secretary. Right. And I'm sure I'm going to do good, of which I have no contender.
Well, I wish you best.
Thank you.
So upon what you've said, I can tell that you've learned on the job as being a secretary.
Yes.
What is the work of the SRC secretary?
Okay, Cyndy, the SRC secretary as someone who is the administrative head of the SRC. Okay, when we say administrative head, meaning that person should be smart, someone who is hardworking, okay, and knowledgeable, because it's your duty to move the council.
Right.
Everybody relies on you, yes, and then your ability to combine resources and the efforts of all executives to push the council ahead. The SRC secretary is responsible for all correspondence of the SRC, deals with other external bodies, the student body, and then handles the secretariat of the SRC.
Right.
Also, the SRC secretary is responsible for having the official list of all subcommittee members and the members of the executive council, members of the executive committee, and then the general meeting. Okay, yes, and then the SRC secretary is responsible for publishing all minutes.
Right.
Yes, when you go for meetings, the minutes taken, executive council meetings, right. executive committee meetings, they should be published for the student's body to know whatever is going on with the council.
Okay.
Yes, it's their right to be informed. Right. So these, among other things, are the duties. And then any other duty the president may assign to you,
right.
yes,
record-keeping is key.
Yes, record-keeping is key.
And I must say, I read the report of the past SRC secretary, and I realized that the office, people who take up that office do not actually leave a mark as secretary. Do you intend leaving any mark as secretary?
Definitely,
right.
Cyndy.
Tell me your agendas then.
Okay. First and foremost, sometimes I'll be in my office. You know, I have an office in Adeshe. Yes.
Okay.
And then some of my ladies will come to me. Nana, I had this opportunity and I want to travel. But then I went and they said I'm not entitled to have an introductory letter to travel.
Mm.
I said, wow. Opportunity comes but once. We all UCC students, level 100, 200, 300, 400. As far as you've been admitted, you are a UCC student. I would advocate that the SRC should do something to aid our hundreds, get the introductory letters. After all, even if they're in 400 and they go and they wouldn't come back. If they're in 100, they go, they wouldn't come back.
Okay.
We should all have the fair ground. We should all be given this opportunity to travel, learn, explore. When we come back, we're going to develop our country, okay?
Right.
And then one thing I would also like to introduce is a newspaper for we, the students, which I would say weekly choice or daily choice. Yes, you know, UCC is the university of choice.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, and then having that as the name of the newspaper, I think wouldn't be bad.
Okay.
Where we're going to publish all events that occurred within the week. We're going to have educative staffs in there, entertaining. Students can have access. We did that in our various senior high schools.
Yeah.
Yes, way back in Agri, we had a most amazing newspaper, okay, where we have events recorded, and then some announcements will be in there. just to know about the school. I think it would be a very good thing. And then also, many at times, we know this is an all-inclusive institution. We have some of our colleagues who are blind, let's say impaired, yes, who can't even read. Assuming I publish the minutes of executive council meetings, how are they going to know? They wouldn't know. It would be a good thing that we transform some of these minutes into braille systems, audio. We'll take it to the resource center just at the library basement. They transform them into braille systems. They can have access to read, to know what
disability friendly.
To know whatever is going on in the university. And also, we talk about information. Some said, hey, SRC did this and I didn't even hear of it. Then I took this project and it's not even necessary. Why did they spend so much doing this?
Speaking of, let me just cut you. What would you do to avoid policies that you think do not favor the student body or you feel would not benefit the student body?
Okay, Cyndy, one thing I would like to note is that when I'm voted into power, I wouldn't be the only person responsible for student affairs in the student leadership. Yes, have the president, other portfolios. When we sit to discuss issues as executive committee, and then some of these policies come in, I can advocate that I do not have an interest in it. But what if our other executives are all interested and they give reasons as to why they think we should carry on such policies, then I can't just come out from the lot.
So you go with the majority.
Yes, I would have to support my executives and then give the students the reasons why we think that it would help them. Yes, I think that's my take on it.
I suppose you have policies then. Can you enumerate just a few of your policies?
Okay, thank you, Cyndy. Many a times the council undertake projects, take some policies, and then students don't have any interest in it. Why is the council doing this? Is it beneficial to the student body? I don't see this thing as relevant. They're spending so much on this activity.
Exactly.
Yes, that's because I feel there's a communication gap between the council and the student body.
Right.
You know, we have the SRC app and the website. This is just developed to aid in communication, to disseminate information from the council to the student body. I would think that we can get the developer to create a column for students to bring in their ideas. I understand that we are in a human society. Definitely some people will talk things that you think are not appropriate. But at the end of the period, I believe that the majority will speak, because somebody can bring in a suggestion and students will tend to like it. That's a clear indication that this is what the student body needs. This is what should be done. And then when you do them, we wouldn't have that situation where students will be talking against projects and decisions taken by the council.
How different would that be from what happens in the House of Parliament? Because I know most students do not patronize meetings.
Yes, they don't go to the House of Parliament. Yes, and then some decisions are not taken at the Parliament level. Some decisions as to the projects the SRC should do is from the Executive Committee.
Okay.
Yes. So once the students can share their ideas on these blocks, the apps, the website, you know what the student body really needs. You do it for them. Yes. So these columns are going to be created, and then they air their views about what they want the student leadership to do for them.
Okay.
And the one thing that if I don't talk about, okay, I wouldn't be happy within my spirit and soul. It's about the security on campus.
Right.
I am a secretary, but somebody might ask, what at all can you do?
Mm.
Yes. In my view, I think that students are not going to leave the diaspora any sooner than now. Okay, so at least some measures should be put in place to help secure the safety of our students who are in the diaspora. I think as secretary, the best thing I can do is to help draft a well comprehensive proposals. Proposals that when we take to the district, regional levels of the security, the police, they're going to take steps. I'm planning on bringing on board the chiefs of these communities, the student leadership, and then the school's administration. We all sit down, draft a proposal, append our signatures, if possible take it to government for them to know how serious we are about securing the safety of our students. Yes, these are among other things that I would like to bring on board as a general secretary and giving the mandate.
See, thank you very much. On this note, I would like to wish you all the best and thank you for coming.
Thank you, Cyndy. I would also like to thank Baba God. God has really brought me this far. Mm-hmm. And I also want to thank my team members. They've been so loyal and dedicated to this cause. Mm. Also want to thank Sister Efia for my beautiful makeup. And then I would recommend her to any of you out there for occasions. Yeah, just contact her. She's just a student like us, an entrepreneur, and let's help her develop her potential. And to you out there too, I want to tell you that I love you so much and would be grateful if you could endorse Team Nana Yaa as the next SRC General Secretary. God bless you.
Well said. So Leonard people, you've heard it all. Special mention to Capital Hill for sponsoring this segment. For my makeup, I would like to thank Ifia. Catch Ifia on Instagram at Ashanti Chick. And catch this exclusive interviews on campus2s.com. Campus2s, tools with a Z. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned.